Good morning, guys. It's 5:20 in the morning. I didn't get an ounce of sleep last night and my stomach is feeling terrible. But I forced myself to have some potatoes down my throat just so I have the energy for the trek. I'm gonna start the trek now to get to Thorong La Pass. Weather's terrible, visibility is poor, it's raining. Yeah, wish me luck. I don't think I can film much. So damn tiring. Also, I didn't bring my gloves, so my hands are freezing. I think there's about 1 kilometer more to go. All by myself. I see it. Almost there, that's the Thorong La Pass. The highest point of this trek at 5,400 and I think 50 meters. We did it, guys. We did it. We did it. Okay. There's another group of trekkers here as well, so it's good to see other trekkers on the trail finally. Oh yes, we did it. So we've just reached the highest point of the trek, 5,416 meters. This is the Thorong La Pass. And from here it's steep down to like 2,800 meters. Pretty proud of myself, to be honest. Carrying my own bag and weight. And towards the end, the 10 kilo, 10, 12 kilo that I was carrying felt like, I don't know, 50 kilos. And I was just breathless at every step. But yeah. It feels great to be here at the Thorong La Pass. This is something I was only dreaming about like a month ago, and now I've done it. Now it's time to head back. Okay, now it's all the way down. Wow, my hair is wet. Anyways, I've been, I guess, speed walking my way down from the Thorong La Pass. I have no idea where I am right now. But as long as I'm going down, I'm happy. They're just abandoned buildings here. Huts. Not buildings, sorry. Huts. Okay, I'm gonna take a break here for like 5 minutes. And then continue down. Ooh. What a day, man. Alright. Peace, peace, peace. Are my knees ready for this? I don't think so. Oh boy. It's gonna be quite the drop. I've been walking for about an hour, hour and a half. Still no village in sight. And I'm exhausted. I can see the town. Looking out, I think. I don't know. It's a town, but it's far away. But at least, you know, having sight of a town, it does bring up the spirit a little bit. Guys, I am fatigued. Back there, I don't know if you can see, that's the beautiful region of Mustang, which is where I'm heading to right now. Today's a long day. From here to get to the city of Muktinath, it's gonna be another hour, hour and a half, I think. I stopped here at this little guest house to get myself some fresh carrot juice. No, fresh apple juice, my bad. And she's just brought it here for me. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Welcome.
So yeah, I'm just gonna chill here for a bit and enjoy my fresh apple juice. So good. Oh, it's so good.
Hotel man, I left hotel man rato just now. Can
you?
Huh?
And then, are you fine? Good.
I'm telling you, nothing is better than having fresh apple juice and looking at the view of Mustang from here. Let's see, this way. There you go. Yep. On my way to Muktinath, that's where I was eating just now. Not eating, drinking my apple juice. Okay, all right, buddy. Easy, buddy. We are friends, eh, buddy? Okay. Okay, another river crossing. Here we go. By the way, that's where I came from. That place with the really good apple juice. Fresh apple juice, if I might add. You know, just admiring God's creation. I mean, I've seen this in pictures, but to see it with your own eyes is something totally different. Oh my goodness. So guys, I think I'm gonna tear up, man. I'm getting a little emotional right now. It's so beautiful. You have to see it with your own eyes. I'm not even kidding. You have to see it with your own eyes. Oh my God! Woo! Tara Mukhtinath. Now I'm just walking down the town to find a place to stay. Most of the buildings here are under construction. Probably because it's the non-peak season. Finally checked into a guest house. Not bad views, eh? Okay, so here's the thing. I might stop my hike here to save an extra couple days so that I can go to Bangladesh, visit my grandma and stuff, surprise them a little bit. But I have to figure out all the buses and stuff from here, which could be a little troublesome. Or I might be going to Kagberi and then to Jomsom and take the bus from there. That will add a couple days. Alright, anyway, so this place is free. I just have to have lunch, dinner, and breakfast here. Tomorrow, most probably, I'll be taking the bus to Jomsom, and then from there, I'm gonna catch a bus again to Pokhara, and from there, take a bus to Kathmandu. What a day. Bruh. This is what you need after the whole trek. Can someone help me get that bottle of Sprite, please? Come on, somebody? Yeah. Come on. No.